To be clear, there's nothing wrong with being reserved and an introvert. But if you're feeling lonely and would like to start dating, then you need to figure out how to be more extroverted and confident. Today, I want to share with you the exact process I teach my clients during our one-on-one and group coaching sessions. They've seen great results with it, so make sure you stick around to the very end. My name is Jason Scott. I'm a personal growth and relationship coach. If you're new to the channel, remember to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified when I post a video every single week. So here's three actionable tips that you can implement right away. Tip number one is to practice positive self-talk. I encourage you to affirm every quality about yourself that you admire. By doing this, your confidence grows and you'll be more likely to be able to talk about your strengths to friends and family, which will then allow you to engage more with total strangers. Positive self-talk makes you feel good about yourself and gives you a personal stamp of approval. With becoming consistent at this, it will make your dating experience more exciting and easygoing. It's easy for us to feed into our negative thoughts and dwell on what we're not good at. Our inner voice can serve as kryptonite, especially if we struggle with shyness and a lack of confidence for most of our lives. Think of positive self-talk as an inner dialogue that makes you feel good about yourself and grateful for everything that's going on in your life. You may not be well-versed on the dating process, but with a sense of inner confidence and wherewithal, your potential of finding someone worth keeping will more than likely increase. Again, there's nothing wrong with being an introvert, but if you're wanting to break out of your shell, it's a must that you start thinking about yourself in a more positive light. The second tip to become more extroverted and confident in dating is to highlight your strong qualities. In a sense, this is similar to practicing positive self-talk. However, highlighting your strong qualities is more projected toward the person that you're interested in dating. When you know the strong qualities that you have, it will more than likely bring value to the person that you're interested in. For example, if you're detail-oriented, be sure that you let this strong quality shine. This can be done by planning where you and your date will be having dinner, and so on and so forth. Being detail-oriented does not mean that the relationship becomes one-sided, but it does mean that you are willing to step out of your comfort zone and let your strengths carry you along the journey. I encourage you to not shy away from talking about your strengths as much as you can. You most definitely will be uncomfortable with highlighting your strong qualities and may even feel as if your date will judge you. But what's most important is you'll become a better version of yourself and gain the confidence that you need. The third tip to become more extroverted and confident in dating is to make socializing a priority. This will be the most uncomfortable and challenging thing you've ever done. It's something that you must plan for and follow through on. Don't sit back and be passive waiting on someone to call you. I encourage you to make the call first with boldness. The more you take the initiative, the more you'll become comfortable with socializing. Getting together with your friends on a consistent basis is vital. While out and about, you may even meet someone that you're interested in. What better way to meet a potential date by being out and having a great time with the people you're most comfortable around? I don't want to downplay your thoughts on how socializing is. You might not value social activities at all. Unfortunately, this mindset will continue to keep you isolated and stuck in your ways. I'm not saying that you need to spend every day amongst your friends, but if you want to be more outgoing and confident, you must spend time where people are. For example, if you enjoy playing arcade games or reading, spend time at your local arcade shop or at your local bookstore. Once there, make it a point to spark up a conversation with someone. It's all about reevaluating your priorities and taking action. If you're more reserved and like to gain additional tips and tools to gain more confidence, be sure to email me directly for your free one-hour coaching session at lifecoachjscott@gmail.com. The link will be in the description below as well. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, subscribe, and be sure to share it with someone that may benefit from this information. So let's turn to you. Which one of these tips are you going to implement first? Are you going to practice positive self-talk or making socializing a priority? Let me know in the comments below. I've got the perfect video for you on the screen if you're a woman and struggling with being insecure. Also, check out the additional video if you'd like tips on how to remain happy and single. I know that this information will bring you value. That's it for this video. I can't wait to hang out with you on the next. Be safe and take care.